Hey everybody, and welcome back to our Bloodborne Kirkhammer playthrough. Alright guys, I have plans for the future, for future playthroughs, other games I need to play. So let's get this game knocked out. We're going to focus on getting this game finished as quickly as reasonably possible. I am so glad I just found that. And I wonder if I can upgrade any... Whoops, wrong one. If I can upgrade anything. Four chunks, okay. Three chunks is first upgrade. Is this plus seven already? Yes, it is. So I need, let's see, five chunks. No, three chunks is the first one. So I need five chunks for the second one. So I need one more chunk. Okay. Yeah. Jeez, look at that. I mean, this is where it starts to get a little silly. There we go. Okay. Yeah, this is where the game starts to get a little over the top. These enemies take quite a few hits to kill. They got a whole bunch of them all together. They do massive amounts of damage, and they can chain their attacks. Well, not chain, that's not the proper term. They can stagger you quite easily. I mean, look at this right here. Molotov cocktail thrower, multiple shooters, so you got like three snipers. I mean, that's one of the hallmarks of Dark Souls 2 was that they lost sense of reason and moderation. There was no sense of moderating the challenge and how they approached it. There was just a let's throw everything at the player, and if the player dies, if players die a lot to what we do, then we've achieved our goal. And as Miyazaki has pointed out, and as I've pointed out countless times before, that is not the goal. That is not how you make a game. That is how you that is the laziest, most just what do I want to say? It's hard to talk and play at the same time, but that's the laziest, least respectable way to include difficulty in the game. Is to simply say, well, let's take this really difficult enemy and let's throw two at the player, and then let's have three snipers attack the player. You know, I mean, gosh dang. And then let's have enemies with a ton of health. Let's have the enemies do massive amounts of damage. Just, you know, I don't know. I do know, actually. It's just lame. So there's so many better, more respectable ways, more interesting ways to create difficulty in a game than the cheap tactics that Bloodborne starts to use towards the end. And again, it's that whole Dark Souls 2 style mentality. Look at that. See? I mean, what was that? More than half my health in a single shot from that guy's gun? And that's just one of the many enemies around here. One shot from a firearm, one time, from one enemy, and something along the lines of like 60-70% of my health is gone. So, I think you guys can see the problem there. And two, making them take so many hits to kill, even at plus 7, which is, this is the area where you just start getting blood chunks. I mean, so you're not going to be expected to be, you know, necessarily even plus 7 yet, but plus 7 is a very reasonable number to be at, and my level's quite good for this area, I would think. So at this point, you have to just consider that they've gone a little bit beyond reasonable with the difficulty level here. Alright, so we took care of that stuff. And now we're out here. Alright. This is where it continues to be quite unreasonable. Alright, sorry about that, guys. I got interrupted, so I had to cut the video there. Okay. Ooh, look at this. Alright. They throw a whole bunch of recycled enemies from different areas, so we got a bunch of enemies recycled from Yharnam. Yeah, this is reasonable. And then they have this super fast run, because that's what apparently old decrepit ladies do, is charge at you super fast. At the speed of light. And and then attack super fast, because, again, that's what old decrepit ladies do, is they have super fast attacks. So this is these are enemies recycled from the Forbidden Woods, I believe, or Himwick Charnel Lane. I think Himwick Charnel Lane, yeah, Himwick Charnel Lane. And of course you have to have somebody throwing crap at you too. So again, you can say I'm salty, but this is just not good design. This is lazy. Instead of creating new and interesting enemies to fight, they just took a whole bunch of enemies that you've already fought and throw lots of them at you, where they have lots of health and do lots of damage. So I don't know how anybody can see that as anything other than just kind of the lazy way to do difficulty. So again, it's as simple as, let's take the same enemies we've used before, let's make them hit harder with more health, and let's make them, well, you know, let's do this. Let's have a whole bunch of them in the same area all at the same time. I have no idea what just hit me there. I've never seen that happen before. He hit me while charging at me before he attacked. Is that a thing? I guess it is. You know what? I can open this. I'm invincible during the opening animation. Okay. And again, hit during the interrupt. Very frustrating aspect of the game that that happens so often. It's just bad timing on FromSoft's part. Essentially, oh yeah, this is cool. And then, on top of everything else, let's have them respawn until you can find and kill the Bell Dude. And that's the official name, is Bell Dude. So, you know, they just have no sense of reason. You know, no sense of balance, no sense of anything other than how can we make this difficult? How can we kill the player? The question they ask themselves cannot be, how can we make this challenging? The question had to have been, how can we make the player die? How can we kill the player? How can we kill the player? Is not the right question. See, look at this. Is this your idea of reason? Of reasonable, of fun challenge? Or is this just, let's make this game as difficult as possible so that we kill the player a lot? And again, once you die to this once or twice, I mean, you're just bored. I'm bored of this area. I'm done with it. It's just so boring at this point. I'm like, I just want to get past it and move on. It's not interesting. Whoa, I barely dodged that. At least he killed a bunch of the enemies for me. He/she. And done. Alright. We made it, guys. We made it. Okay, so that takes care of that for now. And we gotta go back, because if you didn't notice, we're completely out of blood vials. I think it's also an issue that I've been playing this game quite a bit, and just some of the flaws and bad design decisions start to wear on you over time. You know, before I do that, let's do this. I don't know why, but my microphone is picking up at a much higher volume than it typically does. I don't know what changed. Probably just some weird issue with Windows or something. Nope. Don't repair before you fortify. Fortify does the repair for you. Oh, we need one more bloodstone chunk. That sucks. Okay, we'll do that. And we'll see if we have any blood gems. I don't know last time we checked. I just scroll through and look for blue, pretty much. The more blue, the better. Preferably blue on all three accounts. If all three turn blue, all three of my attack options, then boom, I'm good. Because I'm not going for a blood, arcane, fire, or bolt build of any sort. Alright, well, that takes care of that. Let's see if we can do anything with runes. We've got make additional discoveries, acquire more blood echoes, and visceral text grant more blood echoes. Let's get rid of the eye rune for now. Let's go with something else that helps for the purposes of gameplay. Make the game easier. Actually, you know what? I think. Is that a higher level of that? Or is it the same? I can't even tell. Is it the same? No, that's not what I meant. Well, let's select the second one. I can't tell if that's supposed to be a darker image to show that it's more powerful. I have no idea. Raises HP, higher blood vials. I'm trying to think of which one of these would actually be useful for us. I guess we'll go with raises HP. Oh, look, that's it. That's all the HP we gained. Eh, that's not worth it. That's a waste of a rune slot. Higher blood vial maximum, 3 blood vials. I mean, I guess we can go with that for now because we did just run out. Goodbye, Garmin. Oh, and 40 insight. Let's see if there's anything we can purchase here of value. You get bloodstone chunks or blood chunks later. You can buy here for 30 insight each. That's a thing later on in the game. That wasn't originally part of the game. That's from the latest patch, patch 1.04, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. Let's get a couple of these and a couple of these. Actually, let's get a couple more. Let's go ahead and just take both to 10. I got an extra one on that, but that's fine. That way, we have plenty to use on bosses. Those can really help out. And if we get a hit, if we get a charged R2 with the hammer form of the Kirkhammer with fire or bolt on it, and the enemy is weak to fire or bolt, then woo, that's powerful. That's going to be a good hit. That's going to be a very good hit. Stored is zero. Ooh, okay. So that's a thing. That's not good to have 0 blood vials in storage. We've been using up our blood vials. So, well, I guess more important than leveling is blood vials. So we got 54 blood vials. That's pretty good for now. That would have been more than half of our maximum before they changed the maximum storage to 600. And let's head back to the high. Well, shoot, which one is it? I don't remember. I think. Is that it? Nope. Maybe it's the chapel. For those that don't know, depending on when you watch this, it may already be a thing that's happened. But if you're watching this in a timely manner, based on when it's uploaded, we're looking at doing our first series known as Let's Play and Learn Japanese. And it's going to be Bloodborne. Bloodborne's the first game I'm going to play through. I originally was going to do Okami HD. I still will do Okami HD. But I'd like to start with Bloodborne while Bloodborne is still fairly new. So we'll take that route. Yep, here we go. Oh, shoot, 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 shoot. Go get the. Oh, darn it. Okay, let's come back in and try to get that nightmare creature. That wandering nightmare, I think it's called. And oh, I should have used a bold hunter's mark to save some time. The reason I want to do that is simply because it probably has a bloodstone or a blood chunk, and we need just one more chunk to upgrade again. Each and every upgrade to your weapon makes a significant difference in your survivability. And you're probably thinking, don't you mean attack power? Yes, I do. But the more damage you do, the faster you kill stuff, the faster you kill stuff, the less likely it is you'll get hit. So yes, doing more damage greatly affects your survivability. It's much easier to survive if you do more damage. All right. Whew. We'll get through this. We'll get through this. I would eventually like to do a more methodical, slower, more intentional playthrough of Bloodborne where we take our time, we go to pretty much everywhere in the game, we tackle most of the other than the Chalice dungeons. Come on, seriously, is jeez. So what's happening here is that before it actually fully loads, the Wandering Nightmare detects us, even though it hasn't even fully loaded yet, and it starts running away from us while we're still staring at a loading screen. Again, another small design issue that they didn't think about. See, now right here, we were able to get to him right away because the loading time was less. Gosh, I hate that running attack with this. There we go. See, what was happening there, and the reason we couldn't catch him, like I just said, but let me explain a little better. When you're loading up this area, it has to load in all the assets. As it loads it in, and this happens in a lot of games, the point at which the game registers you as being present in that portion of the game world will actually occur before you see yourself. So even though you see yourself appear at a certain point where you're like, okay, now it's loaded, the game actually tells all the enemies and assets in the game that you've loaded in maybe 5 seconds before the loading screen ends. So you're sitting there staring at the loading screen, not realizing that enemies in the game world already see you, even though the loading screen hasn't ended. You don't show as still loading, you show in the game world as being present. So the Wandering Nightmare saw us before the loading screen disappeared. Therefore, the Wandering Nightmare was able to get quite a ways away from us before we even saw the game world load up. Let's go ahead and use some of these. Well, actually, I should have looked at how much it takes to level up first before I started using those. Accidental gesture. Ooh, nice. Okay, that's fairly close to level. Let's do that. And because there's a good chance I'll die in this next area, and we're low on blood vials, let's just go ahead and purchase as many blood vials as we can. Alright. We're at the point in the game now where it is more beneficial to farm souls from an area. Echoes. It's more beneficial to farm echoes and buy blood vials than it is to actually go farm blood vials themselves. Because you can get more blood vials faster, and when you're farming for the echoes, you also get drops off the enemies, whatever they happen to drop. Whatever that happens to be. Today's drink of choice is just iced tea. Nothing in it, just plain iced tea. The only negative of plain iced tea of this type, the black tea, is that it does have caffeine. Caffeine is not inherently negative and bad. It is what it is. I look at caffeine, it's not the same thing. This is a kind of a bad analogy, but I look at caffeine like I would look at, say, vitamin A. You can definitely have too much vitamin A. It can actually be toxic to you if you have too much. But having a little bit is not necessarily terrible for you. By the way, you can do a plunge attack with your heavy attack, and that's what you should do, your R2. Do your plunge attacks with an R2, don't do R1, because for some reason R1 is extremely weak on the plunge attack. Once you kill that character, you then have a chance to sneak up here and try to get a backstab on this guy if you can. One thing I'd also like to do for our more in-depth playthrough, look at that damage, guys. No one can tell me that's reasonable. Another thing I'd like to do is, before too long here, I feel like I'm getting to the point now where I can reasonably do a Bloodborne beginner's guide or walkthrough. I don't think I need to be an expert at the game to give a walkthrough. I think I just need to be able to tell people where to go and what to do and reasonably how to defeat enemies. Doesn't mean I'll be perfect. I'm far from perfect, trust me. Far from perfect. But I think it's going to be time pretty soon to do that. This is our broken lamp that we came into before. When? Let's see. Oh, yeah, this area. This is another area that's completely unreasonable. It looks like they always act. Oh, we got all three of them. That's not good. Now, you can put them right here. The only thing to be careful of is this guy who has the tiny tinnitus. What the heck? That guy just appeared in front of us. That was weird. Oh, yeah, see? Yeah. I think you guys see what's wrong with this. Three super fast hunters who can aggro at the same time. I think it's possible to get two without the other. But they'll often aggro all at the same time. All come at you. One of them has a ranged, at least one of them has a ranged attack. One of them has a cannon, I believe. Again, just further proof that FromSoft is losing all sense of reasonability. Reason. I mean, just sensibility. That's not sensible. That's not reasonable. That is insanely ridiculous. I mean, do you have any sense of moderation? That's not what a normal, reasonable human being would do. It's just absurd. It's just like, what's happened to you, FromSoft? Do you not know how stupid that is? I mean, it's just, it's beyond stupid in many cases. As long as you can get the actual visceral, you'll regain all the damage done to you. It appears that no matter how much damage is done to you, if it was done right before a visceral and you get the visceral, it appears that you gain it all back. Again, no matter how much it is. That's what it seems like. That's what seems to be happening so far for me. This is one of the few areas of the game where I actually approve of using that increased maximum blood vials, because to get three more blood vials for this area may actually be beneficial, considering that, you know, you have to tackle these hunters right here. How can I get the attention of one? Can I get the attention of just one? Huh. Let's try this. One way to know if stuff mandatorily aggroes together is if you do something like throw a pebble at just one and the other one automatically comes out. Yep, see, look at that. It got the attention of all three. So I thought you could separate them, but maybe not. It may be best to stick with the longsword, just because it's faster. Oh, come on, that hit him. That so hit him. Let's see here. There's virtually no way to take a stand against these guys without just risking death. I mean, how can you stand up against all three of these guys all at the same time? You know, considering how much damage they do. They just do massive amounts of damage. I mean, look at that. Look at that. They can kill you, they can kill you fast. I mean, fast. You can be dead and just... You can go from full health to dead in a split second. Easy. Am I going to be walking into the other one, or has the other one given up on me? I don't know. The other one might be to my back, so this could be dangerous. See, look at this. I mean, just look at this. I mean, just beyond stupid. Beyond stupid. Just beyond stupid. Yep, and then the other one makes his appearance. Oh, and fire. Why not add some fire to that, too? I mean, wow, FromSoft. Even if you were to include this as an optional challenge, it would be stupid. But to make this part of the mandatory progress through the game, just how stupid can you be? This is beyond stupid. They're stupid, and then they're stupidly stupid. That should be one down, right? Oh, no, he's got that fraction of health left that, oh, jeez. That they like to do, the fractional health. No way I'm going to let that guy survive with a fraction of health. He's got to die. There we go. Okay, that's one down. Now he will not respawn, thank goodness. I think, as a general rule, they're supposed to get stuck there, but I think if something causes them to come through that path, they can then come inside here and start messing with you. That will throw them out. Okay, there we go. Let me see if I can start, hopefully just, see, now he can hit me with the cannon, which does massive amounts of damage, so that's something you gotta worry about. Oh, he's in. He's inside. And he backed out. Okay. I just went all spammy on him. Whatever works, right? Part of the reason I spammed was not really to damage him. I just wanted to try to get my health back without wasting a vial. Alright, so that's two down, one more to go. Actually, did the other guy drop something and I haven't picked it up yet? Whew! Okay, I tried my firearm, but, you know, it's so slow that it's hard to get the firearm to do anything. I'm pretty sure that was a properly timed interrupt. No, that one wasn't either, I guess. Look at that. Look at that. No one can argue that that's reasonable. And that's not the maximum amount it did. That's just all the health that I had. So how much more would that have done? That's the question. Would that have done my entire health bar in one shot? Quite possibly. Very much possible that it would have done the entire health bar in a single shot. And then every single time we got to come through here and repeat this thing with the bell ringer. Let's do this. Takes care of that. I should have waited till the dogs were together to do that. Okay. Gotta take care of this guy. Gotta be careful, because that sniper can kill us in one shot with our health less than half. Alright, there we go. What a mess. Yeah, the game just feels like it starts to get really messy at the end, where those three hunters are coming at you. That just gets so messy and sloppy. You just end up running around, rolling aimlessly. You know, it's like you roll and just cross your fingers and hope that you don't get hit. That's what I mean when I say it gets messy. A lot of boss fights in this game are messy, just not controlled, just wild, completely out of control, unreasonable, frustrating, you know, that kind of stuff. Okay, so he saw me back there when I triggered his other friend, but I just walked up there and he didn't see me? Really? There we go. Nope. I thought I could get him as he came around the corner. Nope. Let's stick to this one because it's probably going to be better. Now, does he have a limited number of cannon shots, or is that just for the player? Good news is I have a slightly faster swinging weapon than him, even though I guess, you know, pushing people out of range is a thing that happens in this game, just like in Dark Souls 2. Okay. Gosh, that dash just seems so delayed. It does, it really does seem delayed. I mean, I've been complaining about this whole playthrough, but it's definitely got a delay on it that doesn't match the game's speed. The game is just so much faster than the delay on that dash can reasonably interpreted to be balanced for. Problem with trying to interrupt that is that if it hits you once, it looks like you're dead. So, you know, the risk of trying to interrupt an attack that's a one-shot is that if you miss ever so slightly, even in the smallest, tiniest amount, you're dead. You're dead. So, is that the kind of atmosphere you want to create for your game? Like, the slightest little misstep one time and one shot kills you? That's not the kind of atmosphere I want for a game. Like, these guys, too. These guys also do an unreasonably ridiculous amount of damage. And, okay. Oh, is he stuck there? No. There we go. So this area, this is where you really just start to feel like, you know what, let's just skip everything. Screw it. Let's skip everything and just run to the boss. Not worth it. I keep thinking those are wandering nightmares when I first walk in here. Then I gotta remember they're corpses with nothing on them, because I've already picked them up. In this area. Oh boy, wow. What can I say? What can I say about this area? Other than beyond absurdity. Beyond absurdity. Some of the most ridiculous design in the entire game. I mean, just run through it. Don't bother with it. It's a waste of your time. I don't feel bad about it. If I could cheat my way through this area, I would, because this whole area is FromSoft cheating. I'm surprised I haven't been hit yet. That was a very nonchalant run through that made it look way easier than it actually is. You know what? I think we'll go ahead and try this as we are here. I think fire? Oh, and be careful, because they can come through there. And then you'll have to tackle them inside the boss arena, which sucks. That happened to me my last playthrough, if I'm not mistaken. Just try to get around him, do your best not to get hit, and then come up here, because we do need to tackle these guys first. Otherwise, they power him up. I don't know if they can heal him, but I know they power him up. Do they drop anything? I don't think so. I don't think they ever drop anything. Bye-bye. I don't know. I can't remember if they ever drop anything or not. Yeah, I see your bell. Put it away. You're done. You know what? I don't know why I just did that. I don't think I'm really going to do many interrupts in this fight. What you don't want to happen is to... Yeah, they can drop stuff. You don't want to accidentally knock... Shoot. Okay, no problem. He just phased through all the pillars and walls here to hit me. That's cool. That's cool, though. That makes sense. And he hit me in the middle of my roll, but whatever. You know, that makes sense. That makes sense. That makes sense. That makes sense. It all makes sense in a Bloodborne kind of way, which means it doesn't make sense. Alright, so now... Let's do this thing the way it needs to be done. And do what needs to be done here. Oh, I hate when that happens. I'm stuck in here and I can't get out to do what I need to do. And... Oh, shoot. Yep. I knew I wouldn't be able to get out of the way of that, so I just took it. Oh, shoot. I have no idea how to fight this boss without getting hit, so I just take the hits. Oh, no, 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 no. Okay, there we go. Ooh, that was actually an input delay on the heal. Let's see if I can do this. Okay, wait till he's done with that. Oh, come now. Oh, come on. Had to get that one last little hit in there, didn't he? Come on. I need to do this. I need to do this. Get it done. And done. Woo, that was sloppy. That was so sloppy. That was my sloppiness, though. I have no idea really how to handle that boss fight, so I just, you know, I just get in there and attack and hope for the best half the time. That's what I do. At least on this boss fight. I would like to learn actually how to avoid his attacks if it's possible. I know in some cases it's almost impossible to avoid an enemy's attacks. A boss's I'm suddenly from New Jersey, New York or something. A boss's attacks. Maybe I am from New York though. Like some of the bosses will have these like mandatory damage auras and stupid stuff like that, which I just think is ridiculous. Welcome. And I'm not the only one. Very well. Alright, let's see what we can do here. Yeah, let's do that. I feel like more health would help since everything does massive amounts of damage. And where are we at with blood chunks? One. Okay, so we need 7 more blood chunks. That's quite a few blood chunks that we're going to need. Let's see. Advent Plaza. We're getting some good work done. We got through that whole rest of the Yahargul, or however it's pronounced. We took care of the one reborn, which I believe is his name. And we're going to open up a new area. And we're almost done. We're almost done here. Once again, we're not going to tackle the true secret last boss. We're going to leave that for either the walkthrough, the guide, or we're going to leave that through maybe the Let's Play and Learn Japanese version. Probably not the Let's Play and Learn Japanese version. That one's probably going to be a pretty simple, you know, bare bones, like, do the minimum necessary to get through the game. Because it's going to require a lot of work. It's going to be a lot of effort and a lot of work. Every episode is going to have to involve me looking at it, analyzing and thinking, okay, which parts of the Japanese do I want to include as the lessons? Then we're going to have to do the lesson content. The lesson content is not necessarily something I can do on the spot always. Like, I might have to go back and post and freeze frame it and say, okay, guys, right here where we're going to stop the playthrough and talk about this Japanese term, or we're going to learn this grammar structure, we're going to learn this phrase, or we're going to learn this kanji character, you know. So it's not necessarily as simple as this playthrough, where basically all I do is match my audio commentary file to the video file. I trim the start and the end. I make sure the audio is set right, and then I pretty much just upload it at that point. That's it. Like, I'm getting rid of the links at the end of these videos because it's way too much effort and barely anyone clicks them anyway. So I don't want to bother with those anymore. Hello? Why did that not want to lock on? Oh, he probably... Oh, wow. So, did you see how that completely phased through me? He completely phased through me. There's no way he should not have hit me. Or, to say that in a more simple way, he definitely should have hit me. Let's go back in here and get this guy. I think I got lucky on that dodge. I didn't quite know the timing, but I was trying it. I didn't have enough space to completely dodge it spatially. What's in here? Something? Nothing? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Can I shoot him off the ceiling? Oops. You can't shoot him if you got that on. Okay. Yeah, I can. Alright, there we go, there we go. These guys can also shoot some sort of, like, liquid watery stuff. Okay, I accidental gesture, I sat down. Get up, stupid. Get up. Okay, there we go. So, you have to be careful about possible ranged attacks. Not sure how much you can stagger them. Like, it does not appear that I could stagger them endlessly with the longsword form, but maybe with the hammer. I know that there's a 1/3 of an umbilical cord somewhere around here, but we are not going to consume them. Like I said, this is going to be a simpler, kind of more bare bones playthrough. I know we did some chalice dungeons, so we did do some optional content, but that was just kind of me wanting to do something a little different, keep myself interested. I don't know what this guy's doing here, but he's here. And actually, I may go ahead and skip this area, if we can. Booyah! Yeah, most of that area does appear to be optional, unless I'm mistaken. Although, did you need the Lunarium key in this area? See, I don't know yet. I'll read through the guide some more, and then do one more playthrough before we finally get to my beginner's walkthrough. I'm not going to be as experienced as I was for my Dark Souls beginner's walkthrough. But I still have a lot to offer, and it'll definitely be helpful for people new to the game, definitely. I also want to do a Demon Souls beginner's guide. I feel like I've got pretty much enough knowledge to do one right now. The only catch is I need to do one more playthrough as sort of a refresher playthrough, because I haven't played it in so long. I wouldn't want to do a beginner's guide having not played the game in months and months and months. Um, I think these guys release like those little maggot worm creatures when they die, which sucks because the maggots are even harder than these dudes. Like, seriously, these things are so frustratingly annoying and tough to fight. Because, it's easy to miss them. They attack fast. They come out in droves. Okay, come on, come here, come here, come here. There we go. I want to get to the next lamp here. We're just about done with this episode. Oh, get back here because you are Mr. Blood Chunks. I know you are. Hey, you can hear me mashing that button, can't you? Yes, three blood chunks. So that should bring us up to four. So we just need four more. We're halfway there to the next one. And hopefully these are some blood chunks. Be blood chunks. Curse you. All right, now we need to stay out of view. I've never actually noticed that before, the way that lit up. But yeah, you need to stay out of view. As long as you're not in a direct line of sight of the brain up there, it won't frenzy you, which is not something I knew my first few times through this area. All right, let's leave it at that, guys, for now. And I will see you for the next episode of Bloodborne Kirkhammer playthrough. Later, everyone.